Breathe. Breathe. Push. Breathe. Push.
She's arrived.
Yes, babe.
Court.
It's gonna be fine.
Hey.
Let's go.
All right.
Wait. I think I'm forgetting something.
Do you think I should get juice instead?
Look, babe, everything is perfect.
Are
Trust
you sure?
me. I'm sure. Okay?
Okay, fine.
Everything is gonna be fine.
All right.
Are you ready?
Will I ever be?
You'll be all right.
Right.
Hey, sis.
If I wait, I'll make a peaceful body. Not a peaceful body. How long did it take before they opened the door for somebody?
Good evening, Auntie.
I don't want to show me that to my office.
It's right there to your left.
Show me bathroom.
To your left, Auntie.
You clean?
Yes.
Because you know, these days, I need to get power to wash toilets because of long nails. She forever crawl from that kitchen. See kitchen door here. Reach here, give me water, make her wash my hand. Yeah?
Auntie
said you got it for dry for my hand now before you bring her. Just to move your body. Not be like say you fat.
Sorry. I hope you enjoyed the food. I prepared it exactly the way you taught me.
Maybe I don't teach you this one when you do. I manage it. I get choice. Not be you again. Hey, leave this place. Leave them. Sit. I did not drive all the way from Mota to come and eat food. The meeting that you and I had the last time. What is improvement? Because I'm looking at you like this. I'm not seeing anything. Or is my eye pinning me? Eh? She does it. Are you seeing something there? Is there anything that you are seeing there? Tell me. Why? Tari? Tari? Hey! Tari, did they send you to this family? Were you sent by our enemies? Tari, the last time I told you, in case you don't know, which you know very well, that this young man here is my mother's only son. Do you want to close it, your first household? Ma, tell me, if you want to close it, maybe we'll permit you. Eh? Look at me, Adora. I have 4 children from my husband. I have male, I have female. Chinoso, my younger sister, has 2. Boys! Our last born, yeah, she just married 2 years ago. She already has 2 children. What level of witchcraft is this one?
Sis.
Don't interrupt me when I'm talking. My mother died of agony. Eh? What is all this now? Did they send you from somewhere to us?
Sis, it's okay. You can't do this to her again.
I can't do what you do, Z. Look who I'm trying to save from the hand of barrenness.
Auntie, I am not barren. We had a seabed and that was...
That was 4 years ago. Tari, 4 years ago. Eh? That is when you had seabed. I get her before in a property.
Please excuse me.
Let me say it, nothing will happen. Look at it. See the thing you brought in down.
Sis, it's enough. You can't keep doing this to her. I'm sorry, I can't have you stay here till morning. You will have to leave.
Chidoze, is it me, Adora, Adanegi? That's the person you're telling to leave your house.
With this attitude, I should. But because I am a very respectful person and I am your brother, there's still enough time for you to drive to Otta. And if it's too late, please book a hotel and I'll pay for it.
Hey!
But I can't have you here.
Barrenness has metamorphosed on witchcraft. Wait. Chidozie, my own Chidozie, is telling me to leave his. Mwa, bring forklift. I'm not going anywhere. Bring forklift. Come and carry me.
Hello? Ife Imwa.
Hello, Auntie.
On time, Mo, it's work. How are you?
I'm very fine, Ma.
Uh-huh. Ife Imwa, do you remember when I recommended you for this your job? I told you it's for a reason. The reason has come.
Okay, Auntie. I'm prepared. What do you need from me?
Good question.
This is soup. You can microwave it and then make curry for yourself. Right?
Thank you. My online
classes start in 20 minutes. When you're done cleaning, just text me.
Okay, ma. Thank you, ma. Sanu. Hey.
And then I see outstanding ground on my feet. This is the end of the sea. There's nothing left yet to see.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yeah, I'm all right.
That's fine.
Sorry.
What is that?
I brought you some birthday cake for my mom as a thank you for your gift and message.
Well, that's nice, but you should know that I don't do sugar. Doctor's orders.
Sorry, I forgot.
Well, it's a thought that counts, so it's fine. Could you please call Yuka's assistant and let me know what time our meeting is with Lee.
Oh, okay, I already did. He said noon.
Noon?
Yes.
Okay, that's perfect. What will I ever do without you?
Thank you. It's all stamped, sir. Only your signature remains.
Alright, then I'll get this done before I leave.
Okay. Oh, it's your posture. It makes all the stress go to your neck.
Really?
You didn't?
What are you doing?
Helping you relieve stress.
Relieve stress? In an office setting? And you're crossing boundaries and you think that's fine?
I thought you're
what?
Your sister told me you like me and you're currently looking for a second wife because your wife is barren. You know, my mom was a second wife and I really don't mind.
Whoa. Look, Ifeanyiwa, you and I, never, okay? I'm not in the market looking for a second wife. I love my wife and I'll continue to love her till the day she dies. Do you understand? So whatever my sister would have told you is nonsense, rubbish, and void. Okay? And my wife is not barren.
I'm so sorry, sir. I never knew you have kids.
Just leave. What sort of rubbish is this?
Uh-huh. Did you call to apologize for your insults?
Calling to apologize for what? After what you just did?
Oh, that means you got to insult your elder sister some more.
The nerve that you have after what you put my secretary through, right? And the audacity having to tell her that I need a second wife. Look, what is wrong with you? Do you know that that girl is going to lose her job because of you? Or is this the reason why you recommended her? Is she your plan B?
Nonsense. Don't you need a second wife? Don't you truly need a second wife, Chidozie? Tell yourself the truth. I didn't do anything to you. I'm helping you save yourself from you.
Look, sis, for all these years, I have taken your excesses, but this I would never forgive. Do you understand? She's going to lose her job because of you, and this is on you. So please leave me and my wife alone.
What kind of insult is that? Who are you talking to like that?
I said you heard me, right?
Why are you? Have you lost your mind? You don't have respect. Chidozie, what? Did you smoke?
Shh.
Chimo. He has cut the line on me. Hey! Adora, you have heard nonsense today.
Henny, for your tart. Hey, you have been so far away. Is everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. Just tired. How was your day?
It was just there. And I have tests next weekend.
Tests? But you don't like tests.
I know. Babe, why didn't you tell me getting a master is this difficult? These Oyibo people, they don't play.
Right? But don't worry, baby, you'll be fine. Nothing good comes easy.
Right. I guess that's what life is about.
But don't worry. I'll help you practice.
You will?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Ready to take the first step.
Are you sure? Did you discuss with Dari?
Yes, she's aware.
Okay then. I will make the calls and connect you with the agency.
Yinka. Thank you. Honey? Sweetie? It's time to go to bed.
and that I love you, right? I mean, I can't imagine my life without you in it. And it breaks me every time I see the pain you have to go through after these 4 years. Going for your IVF tests and everything you've had to endure. So I decided to kickstart our Plan B.
Plan B?
Yeah, I should have told you before we left home. And I know how you always talk about us trying all the methods, so I'm here and willing to try all the methods.
Really? Are you sure about this?
Yes, baby. I'm sure as the day I asked your hand in wedding.
Thank you. But babe, what about your sister, Auntie Adora?
Don't worry about my sister. She doesn't have to know. It'll be a secret between us. Okay?
Thank you.
Welcome.
All right. Let's do this.
Let's do this?
Yes.
Better. Let's do this.
Yes, so for gestational surrogacy, most intended parents prefer not to meet the surrogates. They would rather the agency play the middleman. But I mean, in this case, it depends on what you want. What do you want?
Whichever one you recommend is fine by us.
Okay, so I will look through your form and find you a potential surrogate.
So doctor, one question. After the embryo transfer,
yeah.
How long does this take?
I mean, right away sometimes. And it could be the second or the third time. But mostly we wait about 6 weeks after the transfer to know.
We will be among the lucky ones.
Definitely.
So.
Again. So the waka so like this, you know, like oh, the waka way, you know, go come back here again with this. Yeah, I'm happy, Auntie Joy. That's the follow you play now. No vex. You know, say I go miss you.
Miss me? I be miss the money where they borrow from me, where you know they ever pay back.
Auntie Joy, what the pin now? Auntie Joy, see, make I tell you, you better say I borrow money from me now. Make I go the borrow money from all those pampy. Eh? This are they will come arrest you now. You go come beat me. Auntie Joy, now win for everybody be this. I saw you go to Wakago. You don't go again, Wakanda. Auntie Joy Joy.
Yes.
So, Doctor, how did it go?
The transfer was successful. I decided to bring the good news to you myself, since you insisted on waiting and being a part of this.
So, doctor, can we meet Sorry.
Mr. Ejiofor, like I earlier said, I think that we should keep contact with the surrogate as minimal as possible for now. Okay.
Yeah. True. Right. We understand.
Hey.
What if it doesn't work?
Then we'll try again.
Again? That'll be expensive. See, with me quitting my job because of this whole IVF stress and then starting my master's to maximize my time, I don't think I have money to contribute.
Baby, it's okay. I got us, okay?
You do?
Yes, my business is doing well. And if the first one doesn't work, we can afford another.
See why I love you? It was be something I did right to deserve you.
You did everything right to deserve me. Can I tell you something?
Okay. Oh, you see.
This is my father. That's Joy. Do you just chow this banana so and I don't just chop food anyhow this week? Not be small, though. Shame me, make I carry banana for now.
Papa, how much are they weighing?
1,000.
Hmm? Is it not 500?
Joy. Auntie Joy. You sure that? Hey, Auntie Joy, after that thing, I follow you talk now.
Because as you see, they owe me money.
Auntie Joy, I don't think you say I go pay. You know, see, what can they move now?
How far down your new job will you get? That dog place.
No, it's that one just did, Jerry. You know, small money will they make from there. I don't wish anything. So just do this thing for me now.
I'll do the transfer.
Auntie Joy! I swear you sure die. Any other Auntie Joy is a counterfeit. Mika. There's nothing left yet to see.
This is the end. Hey. She's pregnant?
Yes.
She's pregnant?
We're having a baby!
Yes! Yes, baby! We're having a baby! Yes!
Finally!
We did it!
Yes!
Right. So, Joy? Joy meet Mr. Ejiofor and his wife, Terry. Terry and Jose meet Joy. Hello, Joy.
Hi. Thank you so much, Joy. Thank you so much for this gift. Can I feel the belly? Please. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much, Doctor. Supposed to get personal, but what is more personal than you carrying our child? Even if you were paid for it, but it's your body. You know what? Where's that card? Okay, here. Here's my card. It's an old card, but I still use the number. You can call me anytime you want, and the baby is kicking. Anytime at all you need to talk, please call me. We are family now, okay? Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.
Thank you.
All right, bye.
Bye.
You can call me anytime you want and the baby is kicking. Anytime at all you need to talk, please call me. We are family now, okay? Thank you so much.
Babe.
The security guard just called. She's here.
Oh, okay.
Why is Aisha still here?
I asked her to stay. She'll be staying.
I see. Anyway, she's almost here, so why don't we go welcome her in?
Babe, I'm sorry, but I won't be doing this door welcome thing. After what she did the last time, she's lucky I'm still cooking for her.
Fair enough. You're right. We only contacted her because we need her. If not, I wouldn't have even contacted her till Christmas. Anyway, let me go welcome her in. Wish me luck.
Luck. is
Is the tomatoes coming? Yes, we'll give you the tomatoes.
Hello. I thought I would wait till next Christmas so I will see you as usual.
Maybe I finally accepted Jesus.
Ah, good for you. That's the right way to go. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How was your trip?
Trip was fine. Did you miss me? Okay. No answer.
Welcome, Auntie Adora.
Daddy? Who is this person?
Aisha. She's our new housekeeper.
Housekeeper what? Ha! Ne, even me. Like this, double exhaust, see my size. I can clean for 24 hours. I can clean the roof for 24 hours non-stop. But you with your small body like you cannot move around and clean as you hired the maid. Biko, Adora, help me hold my mouth. They say I should not talk. So that will not be your problem. So I'm not talking.
Sis, we actually invited you here for something else.
Hey, go ahead because I'm in a hurry.
We invited you because we wanted to tell you that we are pregnant.
Huh?
We are pregnant.
Which one is we are pregnant? What kind of grammar is that one? Oh, how many people are pregnant?
I am pregnant, Auntie.
Daddy, the wife be. You pregnant. Eh? Is that one magic? For the past 4 years now, I've not had bam here. You are telling me you are pregnant overnight.
This one has come to stay because I'm 8 weeks gone.
What about sinners? Hey! Wait, Tari, you are 8 weeks pregnant?
Yes.
You are pregnant? Yes. Ha! Spirit of my mother. Hey, Chino say, I said it that my mother cannot be in the grave and be quiet and want the son not have a child. Ah, I'm happy, oh. Hey! Tari, you see it, my mother is powerful. She has delivered her son from the riverine spirit of barrenness. Ha! The Lord has done it finally. Finally, the Lord has done it. Somebody should open drink because, hey, the Lord has done it.
Just when I think I've heard it all, she comes up with something new.
Why do you think Chinoso and Ezine live far away so that they can avoid her drama?
Your other sisters, they're different. They're calm, nice, accommodating. But Auntie Adora, oh God, she's a different breed. That lady, she can give Patience Okwa a run for her money in any movie, anytime, any day.
Come on, babe. But I must commend you. You've been able to handle her.
You don't know how much I have to pray so I can maintain the calmness and listen to her.
Babe, your phone is ringing.
Really?
Yes.
Who is it?
It's an unknown caller ID. I don't know who it is.
Hello?
Hi, Mrs. Ejiofo. It's Joy.
Oh, Joy. How are you? Is everything okay?
Yes, everything is fine. I just felt a movement and I didn't know what it was. I think it's false alarm. It's probably just the baby kicking.
Kicking?
Who's that?
It's Joy.
Yes, I'm sure. I live alone and I'm just scared. I don't know what a baby kicking feels like.
Oh, really? Okay, please can you text me your address?
Dr. Omo said...
Yeah, I know. But just text me your address first, okay? Babe, it's Joy. She said that she felt the baby kicking and all, but...
Whoa.
Yeah, I told her to text me her address. Oh, she already sent it. Ikorodu. It's on the mainland.
It's already late, sweetie. Don't you think we should go tomorrow morning?
Okay.
And babe, how did she get your phone number?
I ran into her in the restroom and I gave her my card.
Right.
Yeah. She's free, she's fine.
I was leading on the fight, she running for the scars. Was ready for my battle. Why the moon refused to start, spreading out, refused to dark. I was bleeding on a
car. It's actually not that bad.
No, it's bad.
Wait.
I don't know you live here.
Can we leave already, please?
Yeah, that's what we're doing now. Doctor. Did you inspect where she lives? I mean, how could she let her live there with my child?
And how do you know where she stays?
Is that what you're more concerned about? You told us that she was living in a perfect condition. Only for me to find out that where she lives is like a pigsty.
Okay, if the surrogate's living condition is not up to satisfaction,
if
we can.
If? How do you run your agency? You know what? I will handle this myself.
Mrs. Ijoko, the agreement says that you have to keep contact as minimal as possible.
Oh, please don't feed me with all that nonsense. You didn't keep to your part of the agreement. Your agency is supposed to help women achieve their miraculous desire of having a child. And you go about doing it like this? Just so you know, it took me 4 years, 4 good years to get here. Do you know the pain, the agony I've been through? It's just so unfortunate that something that comes naturally to all women has been so difficult for me. So forgive me when I say I can't leave the welfare of my miracle baby in your hands. Excuse me.
Babe, are you sure about this? I mean, why don't you let the doctor and her people handle this by themselves?
They already did that by putting our child's life at stake.
All right then, let's get our own place.
She's going to be living by herself. Besides, there's a lot more expenses. Babe, I don't think I will survive it if I lose my child. By just doing nothing and folding my hands. I already lost one before. Listen, you and I know what we have been through in the past couple of years. There should be anyone or anybody that can take care of our child, it will be us.
I know. And babe, you are right. Okay? Let's go ahead and do it.
Yes.
Okay?
And we're here.
Yeah.
You're welcome to our home.
Thank you.
Make yourself at home.
Your home is so beautiful.
Thank you. This is going to be your new home for the next few months. Come, let me show you around. This is our living room, the dining over there, and your bedroom. I hope you like it.
Yes, I do.
Are you sure the rice is okay? I mean, the baby could be craving for something else. Maybe pizza or some ice cream.
What? Pizza, ice cream? No, no way. Those foods are not healthy at all. There's no way you're ordering pizza. I'm giving our baby that. Should I get you orange juice or something?
No, water's fine.
Water?
Yeah.
Okay.
Really nice.
Some oranges or something?
Yeah, thank you.
So is this the cleaning that you said you were going to help me out in the kitchen?
Yes, this is helping.
Really?
Mm-hmm. All right, babe, I've been thinking. What do you think if we resume date night?
Okay. That's fine.
Yeah, I mean, I want you to wear something very fancy, something gorgeous, sexy.
Okay.
Preferably in red.
Red.
Mm-hmm.
All right, fine, I'll think about it. But then where will I be wearing this red dress to?
Of course, to a 5-star restaurant. I mean, of your choice. Somewhere that they sell pasta and shrimp.
I swear, baby, you know me so well, so well.
Joy, are you okay?
I'm sorry. Startled you. I'm fine. I wanted to know if you two need anything.
No. We have it handled. Do you need me to get you something?
No. I'm fine. I'm okay.
Yeah. All right.
Good night.
Yeah, good night.
All right, good night.
I forgot that we are not alone in this house.
Yes. And she's oddly quiet.
I didn't even know she was standing there. Anyway, let's forget about her. So what was that thing you were saying about the red dress?
Yeah.
I was leading on the fight, she running for this cause. Was ready for my battle. Why the moon refused to start, spreading out refused to duck. I was bleeding on a condo. All the night I cried. All the night I found, fresh with my pillow. I was looking at my window, no bug. You always stay there for me. Never let me alone. You always stay down for me. Never left me alone. All the time I look at my back, you always there standing right for me. Every time I lose all my strength, you're the one that keeps me going. Hey. All the night I cry, you always there where I'm at. All the night I died, you always there to carry me. You always stay there for me. Never let me alone. Down for me. Never left me alone.
Fish, meat, vegetables, and
goat meat.
Yes, goat meat.
Okay.
Then you get me fruits too.
Orange, Abby?
No, not just oranges. I want mangoes and if mangoes are still this season, buy more of it, then pineapple as well.
And if you like say that your sister-in-law, they come, this one will just buy plenty, plenty things.
Not really.
No, I mean, you know they chop pineapple, and you and Uncle Una know they chop assorted too, so why wouldn't they buy everything?
Aisha, it's actually for me.
For you?
Yeah, I'm pregnant.
Auntie, I love that more. Auntie,
wait. Baby, go come and go carry baby.
I said, go carry baby. Hey, go come. Auntie, you know they two chop plenty. Uncle know they chop plenty. But since I'm baby, they chop all the water just to finish.
Yes. Thank you. Make sure you don't mix these things, okay? Mm-hmm. And also, I need to check on my cousin. So if there's any other things she needs, just run along.
And then see we get this stuff.
All right, run along, okay?
Okay.
Joy.
Hi.
I thought we agreed that you're not to come out when we have a visitor.
I'm sorry. I was really thirsty. I just need to get water.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
Yeah. Sorry. Did I just hear you tell your maid that you're pregnant?
Yeah, that's what myself and Dozie agreed. So when your baby comes, people won't be wondering where the baby just popped out from.
Yeah, right. Right. Okay, I'll just run along. Okay. And good luck with your fake pregnancy.
Yes. So we try not to disclose the sex of the baby during sonogram because we do not want this surrogate to develop any form of attachment.
Okay. Yes. So, what is the sex of the baby?
You're having a girl. A baby girl.
A girl?
Yes.
Thank you so much, doctor. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right.
Hey, daddy.
Hey,
mommy. Thank you.
Okay.
It's a girl, right?
Yeah. How did you know?
A mother always knows.
Anything else you want me to add?
No, not at all. I want you to keep it short and simple, so you can have it ready before the close of work.
Okay, sir.
And also, send me an approval before you send out the emails.
Okay, sir.
Emmanuel, do you know of any online gifting stores, preferably on Instagram?
Yes, sir. I know like 2 or 3 good ones. What do you want?
Okay. As soon as you're done with this, send me the links and I'll take it from there.
All right, sir. Right away, sir.
Just sends me this cute little basket with this lovely note. Babe, I thought to send you a little of the favorite things you would like. It's so thoughtful, right?
Yeah. I mean, it must be really nice to have someone that cares.
Yes. You know, we can share, you know?
No, it's fine. I just hope he realizes that you're no longer a family of two. Anyways, enjoy your basket.
Yeah, sure.
Honestly, babe, there's something about this woman. She acts weird. Like, it's not about what she said, it's the way she said it. Like, can you just see the look on her eyes and her facial expression? Like, something just seems really off about this girl.
Babe, I think you're overthinking this. You know she's pregnant, right?
I know.
And this whole hormone thing with women is just weird. Okay, remember the time when you were pregnant and you immediately burst into tears because I was complimenting the woman that was selling corn?
Did you really have to bring that up?
Okay, I'm sorry. I was just trying to...
No, I'm done talking here. Why was I even complaining to you in the first place?
Where are you going?
I just want to go clear my head.
What are you doing here?
I came to apologize for earlier. I'm sorry that I spoke to you that way when you got your gift. I shouldn't have spoken to you like that.
Okay, it's fine. I understand.
Good night.
See? I told you.
Hey, don't touch me.
Are you okay?
The baby just came.
Really?
Yes.
Can I feel it? Yes. Yes. Oh. Hey, baby. It's mommy. We can't wait to see you, okay? Keep kicking, okay? Babe.
Hey.
Baby's kicking.
Oh, she did?
Yes.
Okay, I hate to break this party, but she's here.
Who is here?
My sister.
Your sister's here?
Yes. The security guards, those idiots let her in and they didn't even inform me.
Why? You know we can't let her see Joy.
Why would you insult her like that? You can't let her see Joy.
Yes. Okay, yes. Joy, you have to go to your room now. Please, let's go. Let's go. Here, this way.
You need to stay here, all right? I don't want her to see you. Please just stay in this room, all right?
Okay, so you didn't tell her that you have a surrogate?
Have you met Auntie Adora? She's something else. You know what? I need to fake a baby bump. Please, can you help me with something? Please, just help me with something, please.
I'd have liked some notice or some kind of warning that you're coming over. You know I don't like surprises.
Who would be one surprising before? Me. What did I surprise you for? He wants to pay me money. Surprise. I beg you, Bikokwa. It's not you I came to see. I came to see my wife and the baby.
Yeah, hey, where is Daddy?
Oh, Auntie, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, madam.
We weren't expecting you.
I do. So I should write a letter next time when I'm coming and put it on TV.
No.
It's just that we had plans.
Eh, what do you call cause? I spoil on a plan. Look at this. Una dey ungrateful, no. See, I drive all the way from Water County. We say, which who had to spoil on a plan? Eh? Well, I don't make me vex. See what I brought. This one had to secure that baby so that what happened in 19 Grigidin doesn't repeat itself because I could just kill myself for you.
Auntie, let me get you something to drink. Let's get Auntie something.
Yeah. Okay. You would have even stayed to... Nah, sit down. Sit down. You see this one, you tell your wife. I know that you people are stubborn. Biko, this one, she will feel water. That's water she will drink throughout the day. Biko, I did not mention alcohol in any of these statements. My father will bear me witness. I did not mention alcohol. I don't want you people to use alcohol and remove the baby's brain. I don't want to be chill. Ask nephew. I don't. So water, Biko. This one to water. Biko.
Sis, I don't remember taking this when I was a child.
How can you remember taking it when you were in the womb? Do you remember anything when you were in the womb? Keep that. Your mother drank it when you were in the womb. She's the one that taught me these things. So tell your wife you can't remember it. Tell your wife. Water. Biko.
Honestly, babe, we should have just told her that she couldn't spend the night.
Babe, what do you want me to do? Kick out a second time? No. She's gonna go and tell the whole age of her family, both dead or alive, that you tried to bewitch me. Do you want that?
No, but the poor girl's just locked up in her room. I had to sneak food there to give her.
Look, babe, she's going to be done soon. And she will leave, okay?
Please, I can't wait. I don't know how long I'm going to continue faking this. Why she keeps on feeding me with those smelly, horrible herbs from my naturalist doctor.
What do you know how to do for yourself, Fridge?
Auntie.
Nothing. We're just trying to get...
Then you can't carry Pekin face for Fridge. Don't you know it's not good for the...
For the baby, yes. I know. You mentioned that earlier. I was just trying to get this. Do you need anything?
I don't need anything, no. Just one time I say, I don't tire. I'll go to sleep.
Right.
I'll go back to sleep.
Yeah.
All right.
Please.
Claudia, if you move, thief! Who is this woman? Who are you? Wait. So Chidozie, you give woman belly, you not tell me your elder sister.
I did not impregnate anyone. She's a surrogate. She's only carrying our daughter.
Chidozie, which kind of nonsense be this? Why you they scatter my happy drama? This girl don't get belly. Belly, what they see with my two eyes? No be your belly be this.
What my husband is trying to say is that the baby is our baby.
Daddy, shut up! Daddy, shut up! Now my head won't wash. As I did like this, won't wash my head. See what's in your badness, uncles. My mother be want this boy. Don't marry a different woman. No, yeah. Go to Anambra State and marry a woman as Razu. He said, no, look at it. Look at what you have brought upon yourself. So what you gonna do your belly? A fake belly, guy. What you gonna do is like shit. Hmm? You make the born children with their life. You know, shit every day. Shit, that in the born. Eh, today, we gave birth to a stillbirth. I am not a barren woman. The child did not form well. The eye did not form. The nose did not form.
Shut up! You're such a wicked, evil woman. How can you use those words on your fellow woman? After everything that she has been through? God. Dozie and Tari are such amazing people. They've been so nice to me and their family. I will not sit here and watch you speak to them in that tone. You're so lucky that this is not my house, because I would have asked you to get the hell out.
Hey! Adora! Adora! Am I hearing something by here? So what does it, you're here looking at these rats, insulting me? You're very lucky that I'm born again. If it were when I was in the world, I would have strangled you.
Did you see that?
Yeah, I did.
That was awesome. Wow.
For a second, I was scared though.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
I'm really sorry. I think I acted out of line. I shouldn't have spoken like that to your aunt, your sister. I'm sorry. It's the hormones, the baby. Please don't kick me out.
Joy, you know, we're gonna have a really big problem. That was amazing. That was dope. That was so dope. She's a bully. You didn't know? I wish I had the guts to stand up to her just like you did. I mean, and if anybody's gonna be kicked out, it's her and not you. But thankfully, she left at 5 a.m. this morning.
I'm still trying to be very amazing. And there's no way we can throw you out. You are our baby mother. You're like family to us now.
You're a star. You're a star.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you so much for standing up for me. Family hug.
Family hug. You always did that for me. Never let me alone. You always did that for me. Never left me alone. All the time I look at my back, you always destined it right for me. Every time I lose all my strength, you're the one that keeps me going. Hey. All the night I cried,
You always there everywhere I might be. All the night I'm tired. You always there to carry me. You always stay there for me. Never let me alone. You always stay down for me.
I'm so sorry.
You're lucky, you look amazing.
Thank you, my love.
Wow. So what happened to the red dress?
I know. What this fake belly bump thing.
But I love this dress, though. And the baby bump looks so good.
Thank you, my love. And you look amazing as well, as usual, my
Thanks,
love.
Thanks, baby.
I would like to dress up as well and come with you, too.
Right. This is going to look somehow when they see two pregnant women working with my husband. People are going to talk.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Hey, look, babe, we have to leave.
Yeah.
Joy, if you need anything, you have the emergency numbers, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Don't worry, we'll be back in a few hours.
And we'll get you something on our way back.
Thank you.
Never left me alone. All the time I look at my back, you always there standing right for me. Every time I lose all my strength, you're the one that keeps me going. Hey. All the night I cried, you always there everywhere I might be. All the night I tried, you always there to carry me. You always stay there for me. Never let me alone. You.
Hey, darling.
I think we need to have a talk with her about it. We can't just let it slide.
Look, she said that the AC in our room wasn't working, okay? I think you're overreacting.
No, that's not true. The AC in our room is working perfectly fine. And besides, if that one is not working, she would have gone to another room. Why our room? See, I understand that sometimes she's sweet and she acts normal, but sometimes she acts abnormal.
Okay, no problem. Sweetie, let's talk about this when I get home, okay?
All right, fine.
All right. Tell me you love me.
Then get out of my phone, Joe. Bye.
All right, I love you too. See you later then. Bye.
I was formed from the ground. Nothing left when you come. You took me, but you left me on the crossroad. Was I wrong? I never frowned. I should love undivided. It took me to the ground where I came from.
I'm home.
I have a surprise for you.
What the heck?
Ta-da!
What the?
I thought we needed a family portrait in this house since we don't have one together. I found this guy on Facebook. He's really good with Photoshop. And so I made him do this. I framed it. Do you like it, right?
Well, I think you did a terrible job, but yeah, we like it.
Do you think I'm overreacting?
Are we still on this topic?
What does she want?
I don't know. Why don't you go find out?
Me? Why can't you go?
Me?
Yeah, every time it's always me. You go.
Joy, what do you want?
Mr. Dozier,
I think something is wrong with the baby.
The baby?
She's fine.
The doctor, you said she's
She can go. However, I
fear that we may have to induce her before expected date of delivery.
Induce her?
Yes. Her condition is quite critical right now.
But what could have caused this?
I discovered that she has a tear in her womb. This is usually seen with women that has complicated childbirth, previous history of such. But for her, we're going to do some investigation to find out exactly what the problem is.
So, doctor, what is going to happen to our daughter if she's born premature?
We will do everything humanly possible to make sure that she's born healthy and fine. But like I said, my worry is about the surrogate. The longer we wait, the critical she gets.
They should induce her.
What? That means our daughter is going to come out premature.
No, honey. You heard what Dr. Udo said. He said that our daughter is going to be healthy and alive. And besides, you told me you were born prematurely. Now look at you. Sorry.
That doesn't matter. There's still going to be complications. You know that, right?
I don't think so. God is not going to allow that to happen to us again. Our baby is going to be fine and healthy. I think it's the best time to take it out of that unstable girl. At least our baby will be born prematurely. She'll be fine, she'll be alive, and we can get rid of this girl.
At least let me think about it.
All right, but babe, know that we don't have much time.
Hi, good evening, Edith. This is Dr. Odo. Yes, so sorry to disturb you. I wanted to find out your contact that helps with research and finding out information on people. Do you still have the person? Yes, hospital research. Great. I need a favor. I am gonna send you some information and I need to know more about this person. Thank you, Edith. Yes, I need it. Please, it is very urgent. Okay. Thank you.
I got the information you requested.
That was quite fast.
Well, that is because there was already a file on your girl. The picture you sent helped to move it fast. Birth name, it will be Daniels, or goes by alias Joy Adekunle.
Okay.
Joy Adekunle is a serial surrogate. You'll be her third. She worked with Sierra Agency before she was blacklisted. The story is she became infatuated with the family. She went as far as showing up at the wife's office every day. They were lucky she didn't know where they lived. She kept harassing and calling till she was arrested, then later released. The weird thing is, she wasn't doing all this to get to the child. She seemed really uninterested, more interested with the family. She believed they abandoned her despite fulfilling all the arrangement terms. Her behavior is obsessive infatuation and abandonment issues. Very dangerous.
Oh my God.
Who did the background checks for you?
Casey.
Everyone knows Casey's a lazy idiot.
I know. I messed up. And it might cost me everything if they sue.
Are you going to tell them?
It's too late for that now. She stays with them.
Oh, God.
It's all right. Thank you for your help, Edith. Thank you.
This is the end that I see. I'm standing ground on my feet. This is the end of the sea. There's nothing left yet to see. This is the end that I see. I'm standing ground on my feet.
I need this. I swear as I see you, my belly sweet me die.
Where's the stuff? Where's the stuff?
Auntie Joe, what do you want to come? What do you want Edith to do?
How many times do I have to tell you to mind your business?
Take. Hey, Auntie Joe, it's all right, it's all right. You came out. Auntie Joe, any other way is a counterfeit.
Morning. Hi.
How was your night?
It was well, thanks. Morning. What is this?
So, I decided to make us some breakfast. I know that you both like to sleep in on Saturdays and the housekeeper isn't coming to work today. So I made us breakfast. English breakfast. Come on, come sit.
That's really nice of you.
Isn't it just lovely? I mean, having us share breakfast like one big family.
You know, I called Aisha yesterday to come to the house so we can do something, but now I think I'll just have to text her not to bother.
Over the years, in my dealings with childless couples, I have come to the realization that you have something in common. I mean, besides your childlessness. You all would say and do anything just to get what you want. We are one big happy family. That's a lie. That's a freaking lie. All you care about is just this freaking baby.
I think something is wrong.
Oh yes. Something is definitely wrong. You selfish, lying fools.
Did you buy?
Oh, sorry. I can't.
This is the end of the sea.
Okay. That is the animal tranquilizer working. Yes. Well, I just felt that maybe we could all sit down, have breakfast, share time, family bonding. Before the baby arrives, of course. Isn't that wonderful? That is great, right? I like this.
I'm coming.
Good afternoon, Auntie. You'll be my madam cousin, Abby.
Anyways, your madam said I should tell you that she doesn't need your services anymore, so please leave.
I don't understand. What can I do?
Which one is you don't understand? Did I just speak Spanish? I said she said she doesn't want you anymore. Did you see your security boyfriend here when you came here? Well, guess what? She just found out that both of you are thieves.
Wait, me, Aisha, still? Allah forbid! This is my mistake! Where my auntie? This is my mistake!
It's not a mistake. You think she won't find out that your security boyfriend, the both of you have been stealing all her money since?
I will leave the lie, auntie! I don't steal anything! This is not me! Where my auntie? Auntie!
I was busy inside. I had something I was doing, so I have to get back to what I'm doing now. I say, get out!
Auntie, I don't steal anything! I don't steal anything! Oh.
Oh, nobody should disturb and knock on that door again. Disturb me.
Oh, still your verse now. Because they've been calling him since, calling and calling, so that he can give me access. He refused to pick, but they've let me in anyway because they know me. I'm sure he knows I'm the one. That's why I'm here now. I'm here to apologize now. I will not run my mouth to two of them. I have heard. Hey, no quarrel now. I've heard, you know. It's okay, I have heard. I'm not coming to make any trouble. If all of you will now gang up against me. Bye-bye, you know.
I grew up in the streets of Mafoluko. I was 18 when I got knocked up. I planned on leaving the bastard under the bridge in Oshodi until this kind nurse told me how much rich people were willing to pay. I felt a sense of care. It was like my existence meant something. Those childless bunch. All they do is just do whatever you want until they have gotten what they want. And you have no use to them. I wanted that feeling again. So I reached out to the nurse. And she introduced me to surrogacy business. And then I realized those people, you people, are a bunch of users, selfish, lying, wicked people who use me like a piece of trash and dump me when you're done with me. Oh my goodness, Aisha, I have told you she doesn't want you anymore.
Who be that one where they talk that thing? Which can I talk to that one? Come on, go open this door. Jesus here. Jesus here. Come on, open this door. I go scatter this door now. You keep me for security post now for door. They knock it. Who they talk that rubbish? Which rotten teeth person they talk that rubbish? Open this door.
Hi.
Mm-hmm.
Auntie, good evening.
Mm.
Is it Dozie that asked you not to open this door? Where is he?
He's not around.
See, Dozie is not around. His car is downstairs. Do you think I'm blind? Yeah?
He left without his car.
That is not true. Chidozie doesn't go anywhere without his car. You can't tell me that. Get out of my way.
I'm so sorry, Auntie. I was doing some cleaning and some chores in the house. So, I don't think Uncle is back yet. But when he comes back, I'll let you know. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll see you later. Tell him that his sister came.
Okay, I'll tell him. Bye.
Okay. Bye. Hey! I'm on Jealousy! She look at me. Why is my brother lying inside food now? Barry? Huh? Why my brother lying inside food? Chidozie? 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 Hello?
Hello. Hi, Mr. Chiguze. I just wanted to tell you that you need to be very careful of Joy.
Joy! Careful! You don't talk early now. Joy don't scatter the house now. My husband, my brother and the wife, then they move. Chidozie! Chidozie! Hey!
The baby!
Doctor! Be... Hey!
The baby!
But my brother know they move now! Patty!
The baby's coming!
But my brother let him move now.
You all are supposed to be seated and resting, staying hydrated.
Yeah, we're fine.
Okay, right. The baby is fine.
Thank God.
Congratulations.
Thank God.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Doctor, what about Joy?
I was leading on the fight, was running for the scars. Was ready for my battle. But the moon refused to start, when the night refused to dark. I was bleeding on a candle. All the night I cried. All the night I found, fresh with my pillow. I was looking at my window, and above, you always stay there for me. Never let me alone. You always stay down for me. Never left me alone. Every time I look at my back, you always there standing right for me. Every time I lose all my strength, you're the one that keeps me going. Hey. All the night I cry, you always there with where I'm at. All the night I tired, you always there to carry me. You